Betty, it's almost showtime.
If people only knew about the tension, the responsibility, the pressure.
Sorry?
No, I'm feeling worse. As a grand manager, it's your responsibility to see that the writing sisters are here on time.
What, Tom?
I don't want to talk.
I'll give you a glass of water.
I don't want a glass of water.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, fans of Eddie Grant, our opening act, the fabulous Writing Sisters.
You gotta give a little, take a little, and that's all I'm saying. I wouldn't like to pile on top 3 chips. Sorry to get rid of them. By the way, if confirmation to the dollar for all three.
Oh, hey, you!
In a moment, I'll be joined by the Roman psychiatrist, Dr. I.D. Carter.
was the best trace of Bob the Bag in the whole business, and I need help. The writing is just like that after, huh? So do my manager, Larry Penn.
How can you open an office?
Thank you, overhead.
The manager from the powder of the Jensen Tucker Temple sounds to me like the best. What a terrible thing to say. Larry's amazing in the shirt, but he's so slow.
Not Larry Penn I'm worried about. It's Kim T on Cheryl.
Are they my sisters?
Of course not. Without them, I can't say no. It's a personal hangover. And you have to find them.
Don't worry, I've never lost faith yet.
You think you'll be able to find them?
I'm not promising, but I'll see what I can do. There's a creepy spoon over the corner of 3rd Street Jefferson that we can talk over from the office. It's my favorite. You can fill me in on the details.
Yes, yes, whatever you say, Mrs. Jones.
Call me Rudy. I like the sound of it.
Yes, yes, Rudy. Whatever you say, just find me Rudy.
Does this creepy spoon have a dress code? In case you haven't noticed, I need for instance a pajama.
Bye. though it is beautified. Kind of rattled, shaft and broken down. Still it is a joy and pride. Milk cake ain't as pretty as a picture printed on a postal card. Milk cake where the folks are feisty, people at school are stubborn and new. But it's the start where we were born and bred, right inside the Hog Mansion. Nestled in the Ozarks, it's the spot, milk cake, where we get our kids.
Wonderful knowing about all these big cities and such.
Have you ever heard of
Nashville in old Tennessee. I'm gonna take singing lessons and play bluegrass music so well. I'm gonna buy me a wardrobe and look just
let up, the let up, come on and get the let up.
It's a place where I know that every dream I will fulfill in a home of my life.
Live a little, your face is out of cover. Big and white, Eddie Grant.
Eddie Grant!
evil twin.
Thank you.
Suits I have got, that evil present fuzzy dice, and all they are high.
Yes, that's my truth. You're
Trouble.
beautiful people. Miss Burkhart, thanks for the beautiful costumes you provided for us. You is for the understanding why we're still allowed to dress rehearsal. R is for rescuing us from before school activities to try on our outfits. K is for keeping the order backstage. H is for having all our props ready to go when it's our turn on stage. A is for your awesome humor, which kept us up when we felt like quitting. R is for reminding us not to wrinkle our clothes because you didn't want to iron them again. T is for the thanks to give to you. Thanks a lot.
We'd like to thank Bonnie for A, telling us every day before and after school when rehearsal was, B, being patient with us when we didn't know when play rehearsal was, even after you told us, and C, putting it up with us when we didn't know our lines. Thank you, Bonnie, for everything and more.
We'd like to thank Mrs. Plunkett for all her beautiful choreography.
Mrs. Coconut, there aren't enough words to express our gratitude towards you for all the selfless hard work and patience you have put into this production. Without you, the production couldn't have been a success. Thank you.
And Mr. Brown, thank you for helping us put the scenery together. Without it, the atmosphere for Live a Little would never have been. Thank you, Mr. Brown, for all of your time and effort to make this play all that it has been.
Rehearsals in January, every single night after school. The kids are here loyally. They work hard and they deserve a big hand.